Hello, youths from Trinidad and Tobago. Every Friday 4 p.m., you are there watching this program want to know what's next. So today we are going to speak about a topic very important. That for sure, if you are not going through this, you know somebody that has been going through this. It can happen in school, it can happen in work. I believe sometimes in the neighborhood, It's something called peer pressure.
Yeah, exactly. And it's something that affects the life of a lot of people. And we're going to emphasize more about this during the program. And we want you to stay ready, pay attention to basically what you're about to say. And, you know, enjoy, sit back, and, you know, we're going to be with you.
Yeah, the TV program, YPG, Where Are You Going, is on.
So did you hear about Jake's party tonight?
He's having a party?
Yeah, of course. We're all gonna be there.
Oh. I don't think I can go. I'm not really into that kind of stuff.
I mean, Amanda, if you wanna continue hanging out with us, I would suggest going to this party.
I mean, well, I guess I can make an exception.
Perfect. I'll see you at 10.
Okay.
Come on, just take one.
No. You know, I don't feel comfortable being here. Can you just take me home?
Stop being such a wuss.
Can you just take me home? Are you sure you're okay to drive?
Yeah, of course I am. Like, oh shoot, I need to turn on the car first.
I don't think I should be driving right now.
I'm fine.
Gabby!
Amanda. So the party?
You know, I think I'm okay. I'll see you guys later.
I mean, you're not wanted there anyways.
Why some of you guys, friends that you know, go through certain things just because of peer pressure, because somebody, you know, try to influence you, and because you are afraid, you know, of the people's opinion, you end up going through this. Why peer pressure have been affecting the lives of so many youths all over the world?
Yes, sure. And, you know, that is a good question. Why? Because we tend to make decisions based on what people think of us, you know, what people say. Probably, you know, you're in school and, you know, you see youths behaving in a certain way and you want to join that group. You want to be like them. And this is the problem. You always, you know, people today always want to be like somebody. They don't ever look at themselves as, you know, being better or being above the person.
To be themselves, you know, is not enough.
Exactly. So they want to be like this person, and because of that, they are forced to be in this peer pressure, in the sense where they need to adapt to the things that these people do in order to please the people, but not themselves.
As a lady that came in the youth group, she said that she started smoking when she was 13 or 14. And I asked her, why you start to smoke so young like this? And she said that because I didn't want to be left out. My boyfriend used to smoke, so my friends around used to smoke. And if I didn't want to smoke with him, he would find somebody else to smoke with him. So yeah. I didn't want to be left out.
That is true.
So I started to smoke.
Yeah, and I could speak for myself as it is, because when I grew up under good conditions as it is, but, you know, started to align with friends on the outside. And, you know, seeing the way they operate, you know, they smoke cigarette, you know, they smoke weed,
but
as it is.
But you knew that your mother didn't like this.
They thing. Didn't. They went off like that.
But if you don't join them, you are the mama boy.
Exactly. Because, you see, what they make you do, what they make you feel lower than them when you don't participate in what they do. So, you know, it's obvious that when you see, they tell you these things, you feel offended. And because of that, you want to react by doing what they do.
Yeah.
That is the thing.
But you do what they do. But when the situation comes against you, some become addicted, some end up enter relationship because of peer pressure as well, end up getting a DST or TST.
STD?
STD,
STD.
They end up getting a disease. Why? Because they want to do things to please others. Mm. They don't make their own decision, as you could see in the first video there. So my friend, how long are you gonna be going through this? Maybe you're in a situation now, your life is upside down. Maybe you're not going to school anymore. You lost your job. because you start doing things because of others. And how long are you gonna be in this situation? If you want our help, call us in this number that appear at the bottom of the screen right now. We here in the YPG, we are here available to help you. No matter your situation, your condition right now, you can count on us. I want you to watch this video. We're gonna be back with you right after. This town is cold enough. I think it's sick of us. It's time to make a move. I'm shaking off the rust. I've got my heart set on anywhere but here. I'm staring down myself, counting up the years. Steady. Maybe you are there, you are seeing your friends maybe going down, and you are not able even to go there and speak with her because you suffer a lot of depression. Because when you go there, you are the first person. Why you want to go to him? He's a deacon. He's a drunk. He's that. And you have a peer pressure, and you don't help another person. You see somebody there that needs help, and you don't approach that person. Also afraid of what other people
think. That's true. Because if they paid attention to the first video where the young lady, she was there and she was interrogated by the other friends
about
party. Yeah, to go to a party. And she was left with something major, a decision. To either follow them or be with them or, you know, don't go. And in the end, you know, she came up to her own conclusion in the sense where she decided not to go because she envisioned, you know, probably what could happen, you know, what is the negative things that could follow. And, you know, in one of the videos, it showed you the negative and the positive. And if it is that you choose the positive, as it is to not associate with people that you know to yourself that is going to bring you down in such a way, well, then you need to take the step and believe in yourself and think on your own, and then that will be able to make you move forward.
The peer pressure basically influences. Indeed, you already know that you may have a bad result,
yeah.
But it touches your, you know, your pride.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
it affects your ego. And then you end up doing foolish because of others. But in the YouTube group, the YPG, we stimulate you. We could call it a kind of peer pressure, but in a positive way.
Yeah.
We stimulate you to do things positive, not to bring you down. We stimulate you to be a better person. Even people say, no, don't do that. We say, why not?
Yeah,
why not?
That's true.
This is what we do. Why not? Maybe you have a talent. You can sing, you can dance. The positive things that you know how to do, but you don't do it because you are afraid of the others that they don't like to do positive things. They want to do negative things. And you are afraid to do what's positive because of the others. But nobody can guarantee your future. He in the YPG, wherever you go, he in Trinidad and Tobago, wherever you find the universal church, there is a YPG. But the YPG is not about a religious organization. We help you come out from the negative side, come to the positive side, to make correct decisions. Nobody's gonna force you to not, but we're gonna show you the reality, the two sides. They're gonna be able to choose for precious souls, for free, without peer pressure, without nobody criticizing your life. But we are going to tell you, what's the best way for you? Because I found the best way.
I certainly found the best way too, yeah.
Kevin also found the best way. I was persecuted at the school, I was persecuted at the university, but today, I don't regret. Because people that I knew in the past, that end up going through the peer pressure, they surrender themselves to other people's opinions. Some of them died, some of them are addicted, they became single parents, they destroy them. But today I'm here and can tell you, if you follow the correct way, you're not going to regret it. Every Sunday, we're going to be together in Port of Spain at 1 p.m. in the YPG, the Youth Power Group. I want you to watch this video. That illustrates a little bit what the white people can do for you. What is you're going to be back with you in a special prayer for you that you want to polish the correct decision, make the correct decision. What they're going to be back with you right now.
Something that starts now and can leave scars for the rest of your life.
Having someone shove drugs in your face.
Not being able to say no.
Or that you're not cool enough.
Come on!
You do something for other people, but you don't do it for yourself.
If a friend wanted to say, hey, here's a cigarette, you should smoke it, and you're like, no, and they're like, yes, it's cool.
Kind of sucks, especially if you're not strong with yourself. And it can ruin your life.
Peer pressure is something that leads you away from the person that you really are.
It's a problem that we don't do anything about.
God, she's coming.
Do you think she'll do it?
Yeah.
Hey, Carly, come here.
Yeah?
We want to ask you something.
Yeah. What?
Do you want to be in our band?
Yeah.
You have the best voice ever. It's phenomenal.
It'd make our band really way better.
Amazing. Please. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter. What steps be behind her? Doesn't mean I'm over. Cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
My name is Moses. Before I formed the YPG, I used to live as every average young person out here. You understand? I used to really and truly, every Fridays, you know, the average person wanna party, they wanna drink, they wanna gamble. One of the main things I really used to indulge myself in is gambling. You know, I was kind of addicted to that in a way. So, you know, constantly I'll gamble, you know, wappy, I'll play dice. Even in when I was in school, I used to gamble on it. You know how all of we really and truly like to gamble now, but when you win something, you know, you constantly go again. It become a habit. I remember a time when I was in school, I was gambling, I gambled so much. I even win a match, but I gamble and I end up losing all the money. Even I gamble out my transportation as well. So that day I had to walk and even beg a drop to really and truly reach home because I gamble out everything I had. Even sometimes when you gamble, you start to owe fellas. You understand? You want to win back, that you start to borrow and you start to owe. So you end up in plenty debts. When you go to party, you drink just to foot in the crowd. So, you know, sometimes you drink. Sometimes you don't even have money to go party, but you're trying to find a way to get money to go to party just to really and truly be amongst the fellas. But at the end of the day, you're fighting to get money to gamble. You're fighting to get money to go and party. But sometimes you have the money to, you're taking the money that you need to go to school, you're taking the money that you need to do important things to, you know, benefit your life. And you're gambling it out. I started to think, what am I really doing? Look at me, I duck in class to gamble. I just taking the money that I had to go to school and really and truly better myself to gamble and to party, just a foot in the crowd. So when I started really and truly think and meditate about my life, I started to think, what are you really doing with myself? Where are you really heading? Where I see myself in the future? You know, all this just for hype. But at the end of the day, would this benefit in me? I was invited to the YPG by one of the members of the YPG. Me and my cousin was walking Broadway, and then one of the members of the YPG stopped my cousin and invited him to an event that they had. And he invited him, the way he invited him, I thought it was a party. So, you know, because my cousin was coming, I came as well. And when we came upstairs to the event that they had, you know, we sat down because everybody was saying, John, just a foot in the crowd, but a message that was passed, it really and truly gave my attention. It really and truly had me thinking that time. And that's when I started to involve myself in the YPG, in the youth group. The pastor was talking about that you don't need to be like an average youth. You don't need to be like the negative average youth. You know, it's easy to be average. It's easy to live an average life as every young man, every young lady living. but to live different, to live separated is different. Things begin to change when I took in the message, which was very interesting, take it in and start to reflect upon it and start to act upon it, because as the pastor was saying, you don't need to be average, you don't need to live like the average youth. And you know, he was mentioning the consequences of living as the average youth. So I decided to really and truly start to abandon certain things I used to do. Start to, you know, try to live more positive. Start to, you know, practice the positive actions. And that when things started changing me, gradually I started to work on myself. I no longer gamble. I no longer need to party. I no longer need to gamble. I no longer need to feel the necessity to foot in the crowd, because I found something that in the YPG, they teach us to really and truly be different, to be a positive youth, to be a youth that really and truly don't need to follow the crowd, but you being the influencer, not the, you know, following the influence. I see myself a different person, thinking positive now, not needing nothing to really and truly, you know, influence me, but thinking positive, seeing a person setting out plans for myself and really and truly going after these plans. Before, you know, it's just gambling, living a life of gambling, just, you know, partying, just living day to day now, boy. But now, as a man, focus on my dreams, focus on being a better person, but also focusing on living a righteous life. For any youth out there really and truly facing hardship in life, maybe nobody believe in you, maybe you're depressed and really and truly going through a hard moment in life, you know, and you feel the necessity to foot in the crowd, I invite you to the YPG.
So you saw what the YPG can do for you. We stimulate you to positive things, give you opportunity to do things that you never had opportunity before because we were afraid of fear. Now, we're going to pray for you that maybe you are going through a situation like this, or maybe you have a son or daughter that has problems falling bad friendship, using drugs. No, we're going to pray for you and believe. It's not a matter of religion. It's a matter of taking the correct decision. Join us in this prayer right now.
My Father, in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, we ask Holy Spirit that you touch on the life of this person. My God, give the encouragement to this person, my God, to believe in themselves and not to believe in what others say. My God, give this person the encouragement, my God, to move forward in life, to, my God, accomplish, my God, whatever it is they desire, my God, and not to believe in what people tell them to do, Holy Spirit. We ask that you receive their lives, my God. For those that are watching in this moment, my God, we ask that you allow this person, whatever negativity is facing them, turn, my God, this negativity into positivity. Let this person be able to make the step to come to the youth group, the YPG, so that, my God, they can experience the great change in their life. And we ask, my God, that you receive them into your holy and mighty hands. This is what we pray for in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
So, tomorrow, in the morning time, wake up a little bit early, my friend. At least one day a week. Wake up. Saturday tomorrow from 7 to 8 a.m. we have our youth program, Youth Frequency.
Youth Frequency.
Youth Frequency on the radio 91.9. Right there. Mm-hmm. 91.9. You can call us, you can stream and watch us live from the website that the production is putting now at the bottom of the screen. Look at this. The production is putting there right now. You're gonna see, you're gonna enter into the website, you can see us through the web. We also have the Amplify. 2 p.m. tomorrow.
2 p.m. and we're going to be discussing more basically what we have been talking here.
We're going to go deep.
And you're going to get the opportunity to be with the other youths and experience what this meeting is about for your change.
Sunday, 1 p.m., the great clash of the tribes. Judah, Naphtali, and Levi. Last Sunday, Levi got real leaks in the
floor. Oh, God.
13-3. I couldn't believe that. But let's see what's going to take place this Sunday. They have their tasks to prepare. And next Sunday, this meeting is going to explode. If you want to be part of something great, come to the YPG. In Port of Spain, at number 2 Broadway upstairs, Mary Julius, opposite gate, or in the Universal Church closer to you. Someplace 12:30 and 1 p.m. If you are in Tobago, you can visit 128 Milford Road, close to the Coast Guard, Scarborough. Youth groups there in Tobago also exploding. So if you want to be part of something great, join us in the YPG. Don't forget, before you do anything about your life, think about where you're going.
It's to perform love and kindness. God is the finest. Who find me? Like how we find the fishermen. And then make him a fishes of men. The voices of faith is harder than the rock. Many